JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for March the 16th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mixed against the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It gained against GBP, SEG and NOK in that order, while it underperformed versus CHF, NZD, Aussie and the Japanese yen. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the euro and the Canadian dollar. The strengthening of the Swiss franc suggests that markets traded in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia, but the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU indices finished their session slightly in the red, with the only exception being Italy's FTSE MIB, which gained 0.11%. That said, appetite improved during the US session, with the Dow Jones and the S&P 500 hitting fresh record highs. The optimism rolled over into the Asian session today as well, with Japan's Nikkei 225 and China Shanghai Composite gaining 0.52 and 0.78% respectively. Although the US Treasury yields did not pull back significantly from their Friday levels, investors continued to buy equities, perhaps as fears over high inflation in the months to come continue to ease. Yes, inflation could spike higher in some of the developed nations soon, but most central banks have noted that this is likely to prove to be temporary. For example, the Fed has clearly said that inflation is likely to rise and stay above 2% for some time, which is the goal for the beginning of normalization in the years after 2023. With all that in mind, we stick to our guns that equities are likely to continue trending north, while the US dollar is likely to stay under selling interest as inflation fears continue to ease, especially after last week's soft deflation data. Yes, investors may adopt a more cautious stance today ahead of tomorrow's FOMC indecision, but bearing in mind that when testifying before Congress, Fed Chair Powell maintained a dovish stance, we don't expect policymakers to start hinting that tapering may start sooner than previously anticipated. We expect them to push back again on that idea, as they did at the last gathering, with Powell perhaps repeating that it's too early to focus on tapering dates. Now, as for today's events, during the European morning, we get Germany's ZEW survey for March, while later from the US we have retail sales for February and the industrial production for the same month. With regards to the German ZEW survey, both the current conditions and the economic sentiment indices are expected to have improved, while in the US retail sales are anticipated to have seen a setback and industrial productions to have slowed. The American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week is also due to be released, but as it is always the case, no forecast is available. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.